Hey guys, it's Slave to the Games here with the third full in-depth explanation series in which I try my best to bring you literally everything I can about and or surrounding a specific game. This series will follow along Assassin's Creed Valhalla, a game I am very much so looking forward to and already have pre-ordered the Gold Edition. Thank you for stopping by, and let's start this off with a quick premise before diving into the nitty-gritty details. Some things may reoccur, but I promise you I do my best to limit anything that could be repeating to a minimum. I also tried to get all information that is currently available as of this video's release. The premise is, in 873 AD, Eivor leads their fellow Vikings from Norway to settle in medieval England as part of the Vikings' expansion across Europe. This brings them into conflict with the Anglo-Saxon kingdoms of Wessex, Northumbria, East Anglia, and Mercia. Eivor's clan will face forces led by the leaders of these kingdoms, including Alfred the Great, the King of Wessex. It is during this time that Eivor meets the Hidden Ones and joins their fight against the Order of the Ancients. Explorable cities include, but are not limited to, Winchester, London, in York. As with previous games in the series, Valhalla features a narrative set in the modern day that follows Layla Hassan, a character featured in Origins and Odyssey, as well as further story related to the first civilization. Beings that had populated Earth eons before humanity and part of the lore of the Assassin's Creed series. And now that we got that very generic opening, few sentences about what this is gonna be about, let's dive into the nitty-gritty details so you know exactly what this game is going to be about. In Assassin's Creed Valhalla, nearly every decision you make will have lasting effects throughout the world. Violence won't be your only tactic for getting what you want, and a silver tongue can be as effective as a steel sword when it comes to finding a home for your people. Shifting England's balance of power and expanding your influence through diplomacy will likely make you more friends than brute force. Every political alliance you forge, combat strategy you employ, and dialogue choice you make will alter your journey in some way. I'm gonna go over two characters right now, and one of them we know very well, and another you might already know. And the first is King Alfred. He is a very important character in England's history. When the Vikings started to invade and settle England, all the Anglo-Saxon kingdoms fell one after another. The only one that survived was Wessex, which was the kingdom ruled by Alfred. It not only survived, but he managed to repel the Viking invasion and even managed to rebuild modern England. He is a very important character for everyone, and Alfred will be an antagonist, but narrative director Darby McDevitt said it would be wrong to call him the central antagonist of the game. Layla Hassan is the second character, the modern day character from, who first appeared in Assassin's Creed Origins and then again in Odyssey, will appear for a third time in Valhalla and be playable once again. Assassin's Creed Valhalla lets you lead surprise longship attacks to pillage enemy territories for much needed resources and influence, or launch massive assaults against rival Saxon strongholds. Raids will be more action-packed and brutal than anything Assassin's Creed has seen before apparently, and thanks to, a visceral new combat system that lets you bash, dismember, and decapitate your foes, that's most likely going to be true. Raiding is about hitting a town, creating chaos and making people flee, and plundering whatever you can get away with. Battles, however, are large-scale open conflicts against the Saxons, most likely an adaptation of the Assassin's Creed Odyssey's warring faction system, though to what extent I'm not exactly sure yet. Eivor will eventually run across some group of assassins in England, though at this time the Assassins and Templars are still being referred to as they were in Assassin's Creed Origins and Odyssey, the Hidden Ones and the Order of the Ancients, respectively. As I've said, Assassin's Creed Valhalla takes place in England in the 9th century, beginning in the year 873. England in the Age of the Vikings is a fractured nation of petty lords and warring kingdoms. It's a time when Norse tribes were leaving their homes in Scandinavia and sailing to the collection of fractured kingdoms known as Anglo-Saxon England. It's here during this new age of transition that you'll take on the role of Eivor and lead your people to a new land in the search for a new home. As you embark on Valhalla's epic Viking journey, you'll lead deadly raiding parties, fight in massive battles, and build up a prosperous settlement, all within the historical backdrop of 9th century England. So who were the Vikings? The term Vikings actually refers to an elite class of Norse society. They were a certain group of people in Norse culture that were traders, explorers, excellent seafarers, settlers, and yes, sometimes invaders and plunderers. Vikings left because they wanted to discover a new land and find resources. In the 9th century, the people of Scandinavia had recently discovered the use of sails and absolutely mastered them. This helped them travel all over the world. At the end of the Roman period, the world was fragmented, and the the Vikings played a very important role in reconnecting it, because they were nearly everywhere. The Roman world has disappeared, and the medieval era has not yet totally arrived. It's not only a period of conflict, it's a period of intensive cultural exchange between people, and Vikings played an essential role in that rebuilding of the world through exchanges. England was a multi-ethnic society. It was dominated by the Anglo-Saxons, but there were also Britons, descendants of ancient Rome, and many others. It was a wealthy land, but it was a divided land, especially between rival Anglo-Saxon kingdoms. This was all very appealing for the Vikings, who took advantage of the situation of a divided England. The gods and myths played a very important role in the daily life of Norse people, through ceremonies, rituals, beliefs, and interpretations of the world around them. They had superstitions and believed in signs, like the appearance of a raven. Viking society, ritual, and mythology is a fundamental part of the world. Sagas and myths from Norse society are full of tough female characters and warriors. It was part of their idea of the world, and that women and men are equally formidable in battle. And that's something that Assassin's Creed will not shy away from and reflect in Valhalla. Valhalla's map will include Norway, which players can return to after the Vikings leave, and the four kingdoms I mentioned before, Wessex, Northumbria, East Anglia, and Mercia. Major English cities included will be London, Winchester, and Jorvik. There are many distinct biomes across the two countries, such as forests, grasslands, beaches, and snowy mountains. The North Sea is also confirmed to be an explorable location. There is also a fully dynamic weather system in place, which can allow for large-scale rain and snowstorms, and the snow on the ground will be deformed by your traversal. Eivor, or you, is a Viking raider raised to be a fearless warrior and lead your clan from Norway to a new home in 9th century England, as I've mentioned before. Tasked with finding a settlement and conquering this hostile land by any means to earn a place in Valhalla, you can also choose between being male or female. Both genders are considered canon. The explanation for this is to be revealed. The game's main character, Eivor, is voiced by male Danish actor Magnus Brun from Netflix's show The Last Kingdom, while the latter is played by Cecilie Stensbil. I don't know if I pronounced that right, but her career was included in theaters, TV, and movies. A first in this series, you will be able to customize their appearance through hair, tattoos, clothing, armor, and war paint. Gear will also be much more customizable in Valhalla, and each piece of gear in the game will be unique. You can upgrade each piece of gear. If you wish to carry the same piece of gear to the end of the game, you also can do that. Or if you want to collect everything, that's also up to you. The thing they've tried to balance there in the identity of Eivor is someone who is a lone wolf, who has ambition and glory. They want to achieve this for themselves, but they also have a community that needs them. Ubi kind of plays off this balance. At what point does your ambition override the needs of other people? This is a little bit more into the personal journey of Eivor. Now, there was animal taming in Origins and Odyssey, so maybe we'll see something similar in Valhalla. The eagle vision mechanic is also expected to return in the form of a raven that will be Eivor's animal companion in the game. This will obviously be used like the previous games, Origins and Odyssey. The game will rely less on a traditional leveling system and instead focus more on the selection of skills through skill trees. In terms of abilities and skills, there's also been a revamping. Players have this quite large, apparently, skill graph that they sort of traverse through the journey of Eivor, picking up new skills, picking up a lot of playstyle elements to fine-tune to what kind of Viking you are and who you want to be. There is a rating that is given, which encompasses at some point your gear as well, but it's really about the skills you've learned, what you can do, and that value is rated. So it's a sense of power rather than levels. Now, as far as combat goes, you can dual-wield axes, swords, or even shields against relentless foes. Decapitate opponents in close-quarters combat, riddle them with arrows, or assassinate them with a hidden blade. Vikings were very versatile fighters. They knew how to use a wide variety of weapons, and managed to dual-wield any kind of weapon they could get their hands on. They even weaponized their shields, which is why you can dual-wield them in Assassin's Creed Valhalla. There was so much variety in Viking combat, and that's what they wanted to make available to the player as well. Though the use of naval transport has returned, naval combat has been dialed back. It's not going to be as extensive as, well, Odyssey. Eivor's longship will act more as a means of travel when performing raids and for escaping after land combat, rather than being used in combat with other naval vessels. There is an emphasis on making every hit feel impactful though. And tying right into that is the weapons. Eivor can, as I mentioned, dual wield pretty much all combinations of weapons. The classic Assassin's Hidden Blade, like I said, is back, and there are a lot of famous weapons that come from this time period. For instance, the Viking Round Shield. So they have the Round Shield. They also have Tower Shields. They also have flails, spears, bearded axes, Dane axes, longswords, swords, daggers, heavy blunt weapons, maces, heavy bladed weapons, throwing axes, staffs, bow and arrows, and more. Now, your clan's new home grows with your legend. You'll provide yourself and your people by constructing, customizing, and upgrading your settlement with new buildings like barracks, which can be used to improve your defenses, blacksmiths, whom can modify and upgrade your gear, barber shops, which can obviously change your hairstyle, and tattoo parlors, all while recruiting new members to grow your clan. Obviously, there's probably going to be more. Through doing this, you can also unlock new features and quests. To build these structures, the player will need to lead the Vikings on raids to collect resources. The Assassin's Creed series has occasionally delved into, well, customizable bases in the past, but in Valhalla, base management will play a major role. It's your own Viking village you'll see prosper and grow, in which your clanmates will live in. Big story arcs will begin and end here. The impact of your decisions will ripple through your community as well. You'll see the effects of alliances, such as weddings to forge relationships between clans, and the consequences of harsh choices you have to face. Every building that you place has gameplay value. Every character that you bring into your settlement has some kind of value to Eivor and the settlement. Your settlement can be customized visually as well with different elements such as adornments and statues. You can recruit mercenary Vikings or Jomsvikings as they are called, designed by others or create and customize your own to share online from what I understand as, well, similar to the game's Dragon's Dogma. This will allow you to earn rewards from their adventures as well. There's going to be a lot of surprises, apparently, that they have in store for the longship itself, and one of them is, well, it's customizable. Though I'm not exactly sure the extent of that, and I'm hoping that one of the surprises is it's pretty extensive. There will also be activities such as immersing yourself in hunting, drinking contests, brawls, dice, and Viking rap battles called Flighting. A super small list, but something I just wanted to throw in for you guys is the confirmed animals. And it's very small right now, and I will add to this in future videos, but this is wolves, horses, bears, and ravens. I know it's not a lot, but if you guys notice anything or figure out anything, please, like I said, comment below. Romance options are available and take place in the Viking settlement you manage as well. Valhalla is carrying forward Odyssey's game's advanced RPG mechanics. Enemies will be rated based on the player's collection of skills. The trifecta in this combat system is the enemy design. They put a lot of variety into our enemies. A lot of variety, a lot of unique capacities, a lot of surprises in the ways enemies can use their environment and one another against the player. Now, before we get into the last section, which is the bonus information, we're going to go over some rumors that I found particularly interesting. Take all of these with a grain of salt. These could very well not happen at all, be untrue, or happen in varying degrees. But why would I share this with you, I'd assume, if I'm not gonna make sure that it's confirmed? Well, it's because I found them interesting, like I said. And it's not that many, and I just want to quickly go over them. So basically, some of these might also be like, oh yeah, like I said, bits and pieces have already been confirmed, but not the whole thing. I'm just, well, adding these. So without rambling anymore, let's, well, go over them. Weapon types and weapons can be upgraded with runes. Now this part I do believe is true, but special abilities for certain groups of weapons and durabilities will play a role too. This part I'm not so certain about. And then rather than adrenaline, players can activate a berserker mode that also activates rune powers based on elemental types, lightning, fire, frost. This is another thing I'm thinking, well, half could be true and the other half couldn't. Berserker mode could possibly be in there. But as far as the element types when, well, activating the runes for powers and all that, I'm not too certain. Stealth is receiving some upgrades, like allowing a player to hide in mud, snow, crouching in bushes, and other hiding options. Players can also hide in crowds of people so long as their clothing doesn't stick out. Now this one is another one which I think, if it's true, I think that's great. I think it's amazing. I think that crouching in bushes is obviously going to be in the game. Now there's apparently going to be a reputation system and something similar I believe to Odyssey, but it's going to be based on who, what, and where you conquest. So this is probably going to be a little bit different than Odyssey, whereas in terms of each place has its own reputation system, which if that's true, I also think that's great. Battles between independent kingdoms may also occur naturally. So I'm assuming this means that it's just going to happen even if you're not involved, or if you just ignore it, it will just happen. Players can organize large-scale raids on forts and large cities, or just go it alone. Now, I put this one here because it says organize. Like, for me, I'm thinking, are we going to be able to actually select a bunch of options like attack, well, angle, troop amount taking in, siege weapons, etc.? Well, we will find out, because at least right now, I know we can definitely do assaults and raids. Though how in-depth these are still remains as to whether it's, well, a simple click attack and complete basic objectives, or dare I say it, something more. Difficulty has also been overhauled. Rather than being about enemy health, difficulty will determine your own health, parry times, and enemy reaction times. This is also something that's rumored. Parkour is upgraded with tree climbing and new animations. Again, something I could believe, but not really certain of this moment. And now, everybody, is the last section, and that's the bonus information. This is stuff that I didn't really know where to put, or just kind of decided to throw in at the end of it, so, well, to give you a little bit of a touch-up, a little bit of icing on the cake. Mounts return with horses and wolves are confirmed, as I've said. You once more have a torch for exploring dark caves and at night. Sea shanties are implied to return. A new type of experience is promised, especially with the modern-day counterpart. The Great Heathen Army will feature in the story. Assassin's Creed Valhalla will be arriving on Xbox Series X, Xbox One, PlayStation 5, PlayStation 4, Stadia, and PC. Available in standard, gold, ultimate, and collector's editions of holiday 2020, so we can expect it to arrive around November. Valhalla won't launch on Steam for now, though it will be on Uplay and Epic. The standard edition includes the base game, and if you pre-order it, the Way of the Berserker bonus mission. The gold edition is everything before and the season pass. The ultimate edition is everything before, as well as the ultimate pack, which includes the Berserker gear pack with the bearded axe, the Ursane guard light shield, a new skin for your raven, the ferocious Hadi wolf mount, and the Berserker set for Eivor. The Berserker longship pack, which packs in a majestic longship with a unique figurehead and a set of new sails. The Berserker settlement pack, which includes new ways to customize your settlement, a set of runes to sharpen your weapons or improve the gear of your choice. And the Collector's Edition is everything as before, as well as a high-end 30-centimeter tall Ubi Collectibles statue of Eivor standing at the prow of her longship, the Drakkar, a 5-centimeter tall Viking statuette of Eivor with his raven and Dane axe, a collector's case with a unique artwork, the Ubisoft Store exclusive steelbook with a design inspired by in-game emblems, a set of 3 lithographs showcasing some of the most stunning concept art created for the game, a premium certificate of authenticity serialized with the unique number of your collector's edition, a soundtrack CD with a selection of music from the game. And also, Assassin's Creed Valhalla will support Microsoft's upcoming smart delivery program for cross-generation games between the Xbox Series X and Xbox One, which allows for a free upgrade from the Xbox One to the Series X. And that's all, folks. I hope you enjoyed this information dump, and if anything at all is missing and you have a way to confirm the details, please comment below so I can add it for future videos. If you indeed enjoyed this, then please leave a like, subscribe, join the Discord with the link in the description, and possibly help me on my goal of reaching 50 tier 1 Patreon members by the end of the year. Of course, like everything, it is completely optional, but greatly boosts my confidence, happiness, and helps fund the games I get, the equipment I use, and much more. I hope you all at least learned 3 things and have a great day. This is me, Slave to the Games, signing out until the next release of a video or the next live stream. Catch you guys later. Thank you guys for stopping by.